Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to do actually kind of a continuation sample video for you. This is that iron or steel slag pot skim stuff that a customer sent us from the UK. And we did a sample of this earlier where we ran it through our hammer mill with a 0.8 millimeter screen and onto our shaker table and concentrated the steel out wet. And now the customer would like to see a separate sample done dry. So we're going to take this stuff, run it through our 16 by 12 hammer mill here with a 1.2 millimeter screen. It's going to discharge into this black tub. Then we're going to take it over onto our scrap line and run it up the flat conveyor under the crossbelt magnet, which will pull out all the ferrous and the magnetic material. And then everything that's not magnetic will continue up through and into a different bin. So we'll start this up, see how it goes, and show you the results. Okay, so this is the stuff that came off the crossbelt magnet. So this is the magnetic fraction. We'll get this stuff weighed. Looks like it's about 39 pounds. I'm going to take two off for the bucket. So there's 37 pounds of material that the crossbelt magnet brought off into the magnetic fraction. Okay, and here's the non-magnetic fraction. This is the stuff that went up under the crossbelt. I'm going to try and weigh both these at the same time. We'll have to take off 4 pounds for the buckets this time. Looks like about 57.9. Okay, so if I did my math right, we figured it's about 40% magnetics to non-magnetics. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the stuff that went under the crossbelt magnet the first time, I'm going to rerun it and see if we can scavenge any more magnetic material out of this stuff. So we'll fire it up again, we'll run it, and see if we can get any more magnetics off the crossbelt. So this is the magnetic fraction from running the sample a second time. So we took all the non-magnetics, ran them through again, and we only ended up with just a little tiny bit. You know, maybe a couple pounds. So here we'll get the scale out, take off 2 pounds for the bucket. So we ended up with about another 2 pounds from rerunning it. So we ended up with about 40% or so magnetics from our first run, and then we added another 3 by rerunning the tailings one more time. So be sure to watch our first video where we ran it wet on the shaker table, and we're going to pack these samples up, send them back to the customer. But be sure to let us know if you have any questions or if you'd like any more information. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.